back to this roots. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Garland died with Christ, and we now share with him the eternal glory.
Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is the hoary crown for men, and an unsullied life the attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved, and he who lived among sinners was transported, snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind, or deceit beguile his soul. For the witchery of paltry things obscures what is right, and the whirl of desire transforms the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fullness of a long career, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore, he spat him out of the midst of wickedness. But the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take this into account. The word of the Lord.
There is nothing I shall want.
Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
Charlton Heston, very
and still very powerful. And what protects the Jewish people, the Israelites by night in the desert, from Pharaoh and his armies? A pillar of fire. And that's what goes before us every day after our baptism. Jesus Christ, to ward off the spirits of evil this side of eternity. So today, our focus is Jesus Christ. We remember the day of Garland's baptism. And we ask God to make good on his promise, where we can be confident in that those who are faithful in time will enjoy an eternity of eternal bliss. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of eternal redemption. and Savior, may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Thank you.
to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. We will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages. Praise you without end, Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Garland George. Garland, Big Gar, Big G, Big Papa, and many other nicknames to mention. Father, grandfather, husband, cousin, and friend of many. Garland and I met in the 60s. We were introduced by a mutual friend, and Paris and Bourbon County didn't get along too good in that day. Garland was a Bourbon County kid, and I was a Paris City boy. But we instantly clicked. And from that time, we were inseparable. We went on through many adventures. One that I remember fondly. First time we went to his grandmother's house. And we walked in, and his grandfather was there, and he said, "Papa, this is my friend, Wayne Kendall." He acknowledged me. We're going in the kitchen where his grandmother was, and he said, "Papa, this is my friend, Wayne Kendall." I'm scratching my head, and she acknowledged me, and we visited a while, and I didn't say anything. And when we got outside, I said, "Garland," I said, "you call them both Papa." He said, "That's what they are, boy Papa and girl Papa." And as a footnote to that, his other grandmother wasn't grandma either. He didn't know grandma. She was other mother. So I knew from that point on that I had a unique friend. He was something else. Another story that I remember from our teenage years, his dad, who was Big E to me, his dad came in that morning, I stayed at Garland's house, and he said, "Garland," he said, "you and Wayne, if that calf comes up in the lot that's got the pink eye, you all put medicine in its eyes and take care of it." Garland said, "Okay." So when we got out, sure enough, there was a 300-pound blind calf in the front lot, which had about a foot of mud in it. But Garland wades in, and he grabs it in the headlock, and he's hanging on. And we never thought to get the medicine ahead of time. He tells me, "Why you go get the medicine?" I open the barn door. I look and I find it choked up in the rafters. And I get it and I go back out. But by this time, Garland and the calf were down in the barn. He's still holding on. I'm out of the mud and I holler at him. I said, "Garland, you might as well let him go." And he said, "Hell no, bring the medicine." So I waited in. And we doctored the calf, and we took care of the job. And there's so many stories. I mean, I could go on and on from our childhood. But then came service, military service, and marriage, and raising our families. And we kind of separated. We drifted apart. I always knew what he was doing. He always knew what I was doing. My kids don't know. My kids know Garland, but they don't know Garland's kids. And Garland's kids know me, but they don't know my kids. And Garland's kids graduated from Paris. Mine graduated from Bourbon County. So we switched up a lot. But then came my 50th class reunion, which was in 2018. We were 19, stopped until June 2nd, 2023, when he took his last breath. Two of my latest members of the garden, he was in the VA hospital, and I went in, and he was in, not ICU, but PCU, but it was still family-only visitation. And I slid the door back to where Garland was laying in there in the bed. And I said, the attendant looked at me and said, "Are you family?" And before I could answer, Garland looked over and said, "That's my brother." And the attendant said, "Come on in." And in my mind, I see Garland, when my time's up, and I'm at the pearly gates, and St. Peter says, "Who are you?" I see Garland standing behind the pearly gates, and before I can answer, he tells St. Peter, "That's my brother, let him in." And then my final memory of him, just before he passed, his voice had got weak. He couldn't say much. Kids were all in there, and they said, "Wayne's here." And I walked up and I touched him on the shoulder, and he looked over at me and he said, "I love you." And that's the last time I heard him say. But I would like to say this to the grandkids: we love you all so much. And when you get to that next ball game, that next family dinner, and you wish, "I wish Big Papa was here. I wish my daddy was here." And you feel that tinge in your heart that you think it's hurting. That's actually Big G, Big Papa. He's there with you now. He's found a way to be there with you always. And I'd like to close by stealing the line from Brian's song. I don't know if y'all seen that movie or not, but it's a good movie. And the line I'd like to steal is, "I love Darnell George, and I'd like all of you all to love him too."
Thank you.
until we all meet in Christ in our redeemed and with our brother forever. We ask that.